This is Max. As you can tell, he doesn't have a bottom jaw. He's always mad, temperamental. Got some food debris, probably from the husky. Number 7. F.
No, not.
Oh, this is the 10, and I'm going to use it down the nose. And because this is a senior dog, I clean the around the eyes really carefully so you don't snag or cut the corners. And it's just around the eyes. He gets a lot of gunk, as you can see. So we're going to make it to where that doesn't have anything to stick to. Just barely touching him with the blade because we don't want to cut the dog. My blades are sharp. If your blades aren't sharp enough, it's not going to do this. He does not like the blade on his nose, and that's simply because of his bottom jaw. What happens when these dogs get older? He is a Maltese and he has a really bad gingivitis case. So we also take this around because I know, bud, because we want this out of the dog's mouth. So we're not out to make it a clean face, but we are out to better the dog's life and make it something simple for the dog to live with. Now, like I said, he can get nasty. I know, bud. Let me see. I know. Let's get this side. I know, bud. He does not like any type of pulling, so he's not a candidate for brushing. And we're just doing this really lightly. This one here, he's got matting up in here. I'm not against taking that away so he doesn't get it tangled up. Now mind you, he has very little teeth. Now he pulled away. The reason why I'm letting him is because he is an old dog, and he has, and I'm always checking, always check your blade. Make sure it's not hot, guys. Come on, Max. Come on, baby boy. I know. If you can't go slow on these guys, don't do them. No, Max, put your foot down. Put your foot down. See? This here is a mat that goes to the dog's skin. So, sometimes I will take my fingers and I will pull that away a little bit. He doesn't like being pulled on, so I have to be careful. No. Max. No, Max. Come on. No, you gotta behave, hon. I know, you wanna lick my fingers? Don't show your nasty.
Don't show your nasty. Don't show your nasty.
So, a lot of this temperament is because he's had teeth problem. Teeth problem in the past can give you a problem in the future. So, I can feel my nail between the skin and the mat. I'd rather cut the mat than cut the dog. Now you see how that just pulled away? And it's gone. So it's a combination. Sometimes you have to use a pair of scissors to get the finer details. Good boy, Max. Now that doesn't look like the best job on his face, but you know, that's okay, because that's cleaned out. Now I'm just kind of knocking it down just a little bit on the cheek side because I'm going to run the 7. F. Not 7 skip. Not the one that's got the teeth on it. Don't want teeth. Now this is the hardest part because remember I told you he has no bottom jaw. So, blades get clogged. Look, guys, turn them off. Slicker blade, not clogged. It's clogged from the debris. Good boy. See, guys, he has no bottom jaw. He used to have a little wire here. And boy, you touched that, and he told you. I'm not worried about getting this really close. I don't really want to have to take it really close. But whatever I don't get with my clippers, I will get with my scissors. Okay. And on goes the 7. If I get into a complicated area that the 7's not going to go through, yes, I will use something smaller. But the majority of the dog is a 7, and it looks like his 10 might be the tail. Because he's pretty matted on his tail. Some Maltese, you guys, not a poodle. Yeah, because he sits a lot.
Yeah.
He lays around a lot, so. Nope.
It's
alright, Max. You're alright. Now you see, guys, it's a 7F. Okay? 7FC. Okay? With the grain, especially if he's matted, go with the grain, take your time, know where you're going. This dog cuts very easy. This is the one that I've explained on the site that my husband accidentally matted, got nicked because A, he was using a 10, B, the dog's skin is very thin. Senior dogs thin out just like humans do. And when they're already a Maltese, the skin's already thin. Not as thin as a Whippet, but it's still thin. Let's take my time and work through it. He's not pelted because he's done often, but you know, he doesn't allow brushing. He's very intolerable of having his coat pulled. Now he's jumping because I'm touching his legs. He doesn't like his legs touched. Let me see if I can move this back a little bit. Now, he doesn't have a noose on, he doesn't go anywhere, but I also have my husband with me because I don't do this full time anymore. My husband does. And I come in and help him out when he has these difficult dogs. And I help out by he holds them for me because he knows that I have the skill on the hands to keep it gentle and not nick them. Notice he's just going down more and more and more, and it's because he's an old dog and he's going to start protecting the fact that I'm starting to get to the underside of him, and that is also something he doesn't like. But and as you can tell, I'm getting into more of his matting. Don't feel bad to stretch him out a little bit and make him come up for you so that you can get up underneath there. I'm holding him gentle. He's not, he can move his head. I'm not being rough with him at all. Very gentle. Have some patience with these guys. They're old and they're crappy. They're very delicate, just like our seniors. He may or may not get nasty on this, because I'm on his chest. Okay, this hair, this area in here, very susceptible here of getting nipped. How do I avoid it on a matted dog? See my fingers here. And I come around and I use my finger to guide that hair. Just go down very lightly. He wants to stand up, but that's okay, he can stand up, because you know why? I can get this part a lot easier with him up. I'm using again my finger as a guidance because there's that flap of skin right there behind the elbow that you can catch really easy. Trim it with your scissors, you guys. Don't nick it with your clippers. Be very careful. Now, he's getting a bath, so I'm not worried about. I'm not going to worry about having his hair perfect because after his bath, I'll scissor him, people. He's not going to allow me to clip him again. This is it. This is it. Once you clip him, this is it. And don't make him mad because, you know, he's an old dog. You don't want to give him a heart attack. Making him all stressed out. Get behind the foot here, and if you can't get your clippers through it, you can get your scissors around it. I started doing this dog because of his temperament. Nobody else would do this dog except for he's being referred to as that. If he lets me get his feet. Sometimes he does. Sometimes this is the worst part to do on him. Feel the clippers? They're getting a little warm. Thank you, Kulu. Kulu. And I like this because it has more than just Kulu, and it's a 7-way. Check it. It's still warm, it's fresh now. Perfect. Wipe it off, you don't want that on your dog. Okay. This side. Same thing. Don't force anything. Now, yes, this dog is not carpet matted. When he first got done, he was carpet matted. Get it, please, Max. No. Come on. Come. I know you're done with the face. Hold on.
You got me here.
I know, but I gotta get it. Now you see, he didn't like it, but he still got it. Hi, bud. So this breastbone, we're not worried about this hair yet. Just down the side, get it cut out. Because remember, we can work this part in every other direction. And yes, I plan on doing the sanitary cut. Just haven't gotten there yet. Hang in. Now, again, this part here, right in the elbow part, you can nick that. Sorry, he's really doing his best to avoid the camera. So I just come onto the other side and very gently with the corner, just kind of tease that out. Move that arm. Thank you. Move your finger, please. Thank you. Now he has a mat right here. Which is the reason why I didn't come in through the top. When you do this, you can actually hold the skin down here. So, you're not yanking on it, you're not pulling it out. Just be really careful. Like I say that I can't do this in a 7, F is what I've always said. 7F, the 7FC, cleaning leg. Full tooth. It's not a skip blade. But it's long enough to where I'm not going to grab that skin on these really, really close mats. Just work it. Let the clipper do it. Don't force it. So when you force it is when you pull the hair and the skin and it goes between the blade. Down this way. You see, I'm going down this way. I'm not going this way. I'm going down. And that's keeping the skin from being pulled on this dog from these mats. Now you notice he keeps his mouth kind of open and hangs his tongue. So these mats are caused by saliva. And dog food and water and treat juice and everything else Max gets that runs out of his mouth. Because as you can tell, Max, turn your head this way. Hey, Max. Max, as you can tell, he has no bottom jaw. His tongue hangs out all the time. See how I'm holding him? I'm holding his arm underneath me, and all I have to do is just put my finger down, and it straightens it out automatically for me. I'm not using any restraint on this dog. If this dog wanted to all of a sudden pull out of our hands, this dog could very easily do it. He is not held tight. Where I'm adding on the feet, I just kind of tease it up a little bit, and if this doesn't get it, that's okay. I get it later. Because what happens is that saliva builds up, and in all reality, if I took my scissors upwards and went in and teased my scissors underneath it, place those mats. Guess what? I could take them right off. That was one. There's another one. Tease that mat up there. Go right in between it. Going up. You're not stabbing the dog. And just kind of tease your blade underneath there. Have patience. Yeah. You're fiddling, but patience. Patience. That's all it takes. Okay, he doesn't have to stand up on that end. Now I'll hold his rear. My husband only has to keep him facing that way. That's all he has to do. Check the blade. We're getting a little warm. I'll go ahead and clean it off. Y'all, if your clippers are really rattling, go get your levers checked. Because chances are you need a new lever. The blade should be hot, held tight, and it shouldn't rattle. Okay, back area. Again, he's matted, for sure. This tail, we'll see. I might show you how I'll splice it to get it real. Oh, he got fleas. Mm-hmm. He's got fleas. Mm-hmm. I just saw one. We use a filthy animal as a general shampoo. It's a flea killing shampoo as well. It's really great by Kelco. We use it as a general shampoo because generally majority of dogs do have a flea from somewhere. If you have any cats around, it's cat fleas. They're just as bad. And it works for cats too. It's a shampoo, it's not a leave-in. Does have a residue of about 7 days. Not a treatment, can be used in with treatments, whether oral or topical. Clippers walk. Don't force them down in there. Let them walk. That's what they're meant for. Let them do the work. See there? Now you're going to see me always use my fingers. Because I'd rather have the clippers hit me first than the dog. That and I can keep the skin from pulling. Notice how I'm pulling the hair out away from the dog's skin. There's mats. And I want to go under them, so I'm not going to force the blade through. I'll pull it out away from the skin a little bit. If it didn't go through, if I had any problems getting around the legs or anything like that, you darn right, I'll throw the tail pin on and gently work that through. It all has to be done gently. Last leg, then we'll do a sanitary. And then I'll do the back feet. Then we'll do the tail. See? I did not go down. I went this way to cut that. And I did it because there was mats. Grab the hair, pull the hair out, just slide underneath it. Because when you go above it, you're going to catch the mats that are on top. Dan, my husband, lift them up so that I can get to the back. Because he's less squirrely up here than he is when he's able to get all scrunched up together. I almost thought I was going to have to split mats again, but it looks like, again, my 7F is going to work through it. Very lightly, very gently. And I'm going with the grain because I don't want anything to snag. Now, the groomers out there that's been grooming for a long time, I'm not trying to tell you guys how to groom. All I'm saying is this is another way to work with senior, uncooperative babies. Now, I have one back leg, or one back foot, to finish. I'm not holding the leg out. I'm holding the leg up under the dog. If the dog wanted to, they can actually use that muscle power to push up off of my hand with their back leg. And the reason why I do that is it creates less of a fuss. And if I'm working on the opposite leg, if he picks it up, he's going to pull it away from the clippers. He's not going to go with it. Now I just did that for the inside of that leg. Again, I ask my hands or my fingers to pick that up a little bit because it is knotted. And like I said, he's fussy with his feet. So I don't want him to be uncomfortable. He's got a lot of support between my husband and I. Good boy, Max. Good boy, Max. So good. Now, I don't care that there's hair hanging off his feet right now. Let me switch back over to the number 10. Where'd it go? 10. And I'm going to have him hold him up so that I can do work on the sanitary. So the butt first. Now, mind you, this is pretty bad, you guys. He's a Maltese. So, I'm going to start out. Me and my fingers always in the way. But I don't want it to cut him. Staying with the hair. The way the hair grows. And if I have to go against, I try to make sure that my finger is there for the guiding. He does not like having his butt done. This is really the first time he's actually been this good. So, splicing. I'm not going down. Going to come up. And I'm only going to do it so that I know I can get my blade there. See? I can get my blade in that. Get the hair off the skin. Get splice that mat. See here? Tell me a 7. Okay. Watch. The seven's gonna do it. And I will not make this stop. Okay, seven up. Prove you guys. Come to a pocket that you can't get through. Put a hole with your fingers so that you know that you have a hole. Go open the dog. Splice that mat. I have this much room to get underneath this, but it didn't look like it. See, I'll try to show you. I have this much room to get underneath it. Okay? More than enough for a 7F. Sorry, bud. That was the arm. He doesn't need it, so we didn't need to bring it in, but we did. Just work it. Underneath here is better. Long. I'm not going into the dog. I'm coming up. And you're going to splice that mat.
I need your tail, bud. It's not done yet.
And there. Use your fingers a little bit, pull it apart. Make sure you get down there.
Now that's the tip of my tail. You got your tail back. Yes, you do.
Okay. Back to a 10. Got the pads to do. Got the belly to do. Then he's ready for his bath after I brush his ears out. I'm going to pause the video. And we'll continue once he is dry and ready for his finishing. Now, these are matted, so I'm going to cut off the tops first before I dig into his feet.
Leave alone.
As you can tell, I'm always holding the foot up underneath the dog. It takes away their ability to yank. And it really does work. So try holding the feet up underneath the dog. You're not pulling them out, so you're not stretching their legs, you're not going to give them sore muscles. After the bath. Alright, go ahead and turn them around and pull them up.
Spread eagle's blood.
So, pinching inside legs. Common in older dogs. Take your opposite leg, stand him up. Look, he's not pinching you guys. Here you can go up against. I am using my tan. Do not touch the skin on the inside of the belly. Stop. We're going to come out at a different angle, that's why. And then we have this area and this area. Going with the grain, especially at first, especially if they're matted on their belly. Like he is, and you see he squinches in, so give him, take back that leg. Don't move him. Take back that leg. And we're gonna go. Now mind you, he's really, really sensitive to clippers. Now, no, I'm not going down his wee wee going this way. I'm getting the hair in this ball sack area that goes that way. He is neutered, so I don't have to worry about nipping balls. Testicles. Good boy. Yeah. Do the same thing at the opposite. I'm just picking the foot up. This foot's actually balanced really well in my hand. If you wanted to all of a sudden put weight to lift the other foot, pull it. That's the way he has to do it. And I'm going down the leg with the grain, across the leg with the grain, inside with the grain. Okay. Come on. I'm going to go this way. Okay. Now, we're going to open that up so that we can get in there and go with the grain. When you have skin-sensitive dogs, never, ever go against the grain. Because then, you're going to irritate the skin. Again, I'm holding him with my hand, and I'm just keeping his foot underneath me. Not twisted or anything else. Other side, do the same. That's good boy. That's a good boy. That's a good boy. Turn him back around, and this time we're going to have to stand him straight up. Or actually, we'll just stand him straight up this way. Let's put the feet down, Mac. Thank you. I need this foot further out. That's the foot I'm shaving. It's the one that you're just wearing. I'm shaving the one you're holding.
I know.
Your thumb's in my way. I can't get to it.
Wrong person holding.
Huh?
Wrong person holding.
So for an old dog, that's good enough. Okay? We're not after doing everything perfect. It's an old dog. Don't stress over perfection when it comes to a dog that is a senior and hard to keep in an area. And yeah, he's uneven. But he's not going to be uneven completely. Okay. I gotta do the front. Now, he knows I'm doing his front paw, so as you can tell, he's doing his best, keeping his paw. So I'm gonna ask, but I'm gonna let him keep it. I'm not gonna fight him. And like I say, shed the top first, get all that extra hair before you dig in there so you know where you're going. Good enough. Don't be picky, because the dog's not gonna like it. And I'm not pulling his foot completely out, I'm just holding it up, bringing it to the front of him, keeping it comfortable. I'm not gonna fight him. If I pulled it out in front of him, either the dog's gonna come with me or he's gonna snap at me. And we don't want that either. Because this one will snap. You guys saw that at the beginning. He did snap. He does snap. He don't have teeth. But he doesn't. When a dog says no, that's it. You know? You have to understand what they're saying. Hey, bud. Hey, bud. Hey, bud. Where are you going? Where are you going? See? Where are you going? Come on. Just get what you can. The rest of it's scissors. When they get this old, you can't get perfection. I don't care how much you try. But you gotta give in to something. Now I'm brushing my fingers, so you know, because your leather ends up here. I'm not brushing that out. Trim all of that and he gets out of the bath. Alright, guys, I'm pausing this. He's ready for his bath. You'll see backs. Oh, did want to point out, you guys were talking about, somebody posted about the seborrhea. And this dog has it too. And that's how come I know what it is. It's a seborrhea. It's just a skin infection. Usually it has that bacteria. Have your vet scrape it. Take a look if you see it. Clients come in. Okay.